Ladies and gentlemen, my pleasure to introduce to you Tiffany. Tiffany is a guest of my beautiful wife, Mary Cromings. She DM'd my wife and said, I'd love to get a pixie. She showed her a couple of pictures. Mary said, we're making this beautiful hair show for Black Lives Matter, working with Ryan. And how would you like to model for Robert, my husband? Now, I've never met Tiffany before, to my knowledge. Not that this is a magical trick. But what she generally has done through the history with my wife is she's, you know, got very short haircuts, big transformations, whether it was shoulder length as it is today, going up to a bob. And Mary's had a lot of fun with the interaction, but she loves change. And she showed me variations of a pixie. So we did some picture exchanges. We did a great consultation with our masks on. And I thought we'd start the journey with a beautiful wash house experience. So right now, Mary's setting up the hair for me, as she always does. I'm using the Paul Mitchell straight razor, double-sided foil blades, elevation quite high on top of the head, and then over direction from underneath, kind of keeping it very horizontal. And this will sort of protect a little bit of the hairline hair so I can work on that later. Kind of working with a small sort of stroke to it because I want those edges on the outside to get a kind of stone-washed feeling. So I cut both sides in the front first. What's kind of critical to me on this particular technique is having the ability to kind of match the most important balance points. Now, when I say match, you know, they got to be similar. I like to wear hats on the side a little bit. I'm not looking for a symmetry, perhaps, but I'm just looking for a nice little balance that frames beautiful Tiffany's face and gives me what I'm looking for. So I kind of lock my fingers in a certain position so my hand's not pulling away constantly. And through that locked finger position, I'm able to release through the magic of the Paul Mitchell razor. It's extremely sharp. There's a bit of product in the hair. I think I use sculpting foam, so it gives it a little bit of slip. And again, the hair's quite wet, which I really do advise on most of your razor work. So I'm giving a little visual check to that, just seeing how it's working. You know, to me, when I'm doing hair, all I really care about is the face. It's Tiffany's face. It's what does it look like on her? And a lot of times when I was a young man cutting hair behind the model, behind the client, a lot of things would happen for the haircut that looked awesome, but it didn't really make the same connection on the facial features. I used to love to hear Vidal talk about the jawline, you know, the lip line and all the things he made a big deal about. To me, a lot of what I do on stage has a lot to do with just finding the beauty in a face and going for it. And that's kind of a rule I follow. So the same sort of technique all the way through the head. You're trying to match the elevation. Obviously, because of the underneath dragging up, which takes a little more combing, you already get that beautiful soft outline. This is what I learned from Paul Mitchell, the man, condensed cutting. So it's fewer sections, more meaning. And what that means for you and guys out there who love to cut hair precision-wise, the precision I'm using here is coming from my comb. So it's about the consistency between that up and down kind of motion between the surface at the top and the drag from underneath, and then how much elevation. And to me, the key thing that makes this haircut particularly different, I'm quite high on the head here. I'm not pulling it down to a weight line position. So even though there's going to be a bit of weight and a release to underneath, I'm not getting a big bulb of one length hair up top, which is something I'm trying to avoid on this particular transformation. I think going from long hair to a pixie is challenging, unless you've got a couple of hours or you want to take it section by section, which is beautiful and rewarding. But again, I'm going to follow my platform artist instinct. I like to make changes quickly, and by not overthinking the situation, I tend to leave myself more options. And you know, sometimes we may have agreed, even with Tiffany's hair, that we could go super short pixie. That's not always my first interpretation, especially I wanted to take advantage of her beautiful hair, and it's got this incredible texture to it. So I want to keep and maintain that and give it something that works there. And again, I could always see Tiffany in a few weeks and we could go obviously shorter. Making things longer is impossible in a day's journey. So again, little checking how things are falling. I'm not a big cross checker. I check with my eyes, I check with my touch. And again, not saying cross checking is bad. Just saying for the way that I cut hair, I stopped cross checking work because I was so disappointed in the results. I'm trying to make it lay on the head. I'm trying to make it react to the type of technique I'm using. And with the razor, it creates such forgiveness and at the same time, quite a lot of control, which is something people lack when they're using a razor. So control the hair, it controls you. I still follow those principles. And again, just looking to see how Tiffany's hair is living and breathing, trying to assess it for what it's actually doing, not just the intent I had when I started. So she has a high level of activity in her life. She works out, she's a teacher, instructor. So I want to make sure this fits her. So I want to do a little face framing, trying to maintain some of that outer perimeter, that little skirt level, if you will, but at the same time, giving an ability to tuck in behind the ear, sit small on the head, so that she's not always compacted with a lot of volume when she's doing her workouts. So just a little bit of extra forward direction, and this kind of complements what I've done in the inside already, but just to put a little innuendo, if you will, or memory, if you will, to the haircut from the front to the back. So it kind of makes it quite easy. And now I'm just going to go inside on the bottom geometry. And again, it is geometry depending on how close to the head we cut it. So I want to give it a little soft outline. And I don't think there's a better tool on the planet than the razor for this. You can see me.